Hey everyone, I hope you are doing well. Today I wanted to share what I'm gifting my husband for Christmas. So I recently shared what we are gifting our son, who will be 3 right after Christmas. However, today I wanted to share what I purchased for my husband before I wrap it, because I feel like men can be tricky or hard to purchase for, especially, one of his gifts fell, especially if it's someone who you're purchasing for every single year. For me, I feel like I get to a point where I purchase them everything I feel like they would like. So then I'm just stuck on thinking of what they would appreciate or what they would like. So I'm always looking for new ideas of things to get. So with him, we typically do a big gift each and then we do stockings, but this year we really didn't have a big thing we really wanted. So I kind of had to be creative with what I purchased for him and what I thought that he would want, or things that he's just mentioned to me that I've made note of that I haven't already given ideas to our families. So that's another tricky part, is if you are giving gift ideas to family members. So for example, both of our parents want ideas of things he can actually open. So I tend to give them things that he's mentioned to me and that I know he for sure wants first, or if he does have anything on our Amazon list. And then I'm kind of stuck with things that I just have to be creative with or think outside the box a little bit. So that's kind of how we do it. This year, like I said, it's a little bit different, but I know these are going to be things that he loves. He really won't be expecting, and I know he'll be excited about it. He truly doesn't know what I purchased for him. I'm the one who checks all of our accounts. I do, everything's linked to my email. So he really, when he opens it on Christmas Day, is truly surprised, which is fun. So the first thing, it fell, but the first thing that I got him is he wanted this golf ball thing that like picks up golf balls. I have no idea what it is, but it was the last thing on our Amazon list that was not taken from one of our family members. So I think it was around $30, $40. So I purchased that because I knew he would want it. But like I said, I don't know the exact name, but I'll look through our orders and I'll link it below in case you have someone who's into golf. But he is getting like a golf net to practice out in the backyard from his mom. So he did have a few golf things on there that I know that he will like, but that was the only thing from our Amazon list that I could purchase. Another thing I got for him, he will be super excited about, is a new belt, which he has mentioned now for maybe a year. So this was tricky because he was set on having a genuine leather belt, which if you go places, a lot of places don't have genuine leather, which is surprising to me. So I decided to just go ahead and order one from Brooks Brothers because they are made in Italy. They're really good quality. My brother-in-law has them. He loves them. So he said that it's definitely worth the money. This belt was $98, so they're definitely not cheap. But like I said, it's something that he's going to wear every day and that lasts a really long time. His other belt that he wears every day right now, he's probably had 10 plus years, but it was just time for a new one. He's lost some weight over the years, so he needed a new belt size, and it's just good quality and something nice to have. So like I said, this is from Brooks Brothers. I will leave the actual Brooks Brothers link below, but he definitely will be excited about that. Then another thing he has mentioned casually is new house shoes. So last year I got him some house shoes, I think from Nordstrom or Nordstrom Rack, and he loved them, but I mean, he has just completely worn them out. He also had mentioned to me that the next one that he gets, he wanted them to be more breathable because, you know, your feet kind of get sweaty if you're wearing slippers or house shoes. So I just got some cheaper ones at Target. These were $18, but they're really nice. They're kind of like that memory foam. Obviously, it's way more breathable than having the whole toe enclosed. Then they have the hard sole, which both of us love, so we can go outside, take out the trash, all of that. But if he doesn't like them, it's okay. I mean, they're only $18, but I do think he'll really like these, and I do like the color. And this Goodfellow brand from Target, they have a lot of good stuff. I feel like I've purchased a lot of their brand. So that's another thing he's getting. Another gift he's getting is just like a sample pack of this Jack Black brand. So I was purchasing a couple gifts for my girlfriends from Sephora, and then I saw this and I figured I'd get it for Mason to try. So it has like a face cleanser, a moisturizer, and then like a hair and body. So he may not use this like daily in the shower to try. It may be something that he uses traveling, which is totally fine with me, but I figured that he would just like trying a new brand. And I feel like now we're getting to the age where you kind of get excited and appreciate things like this. So I feel like he actually will like this, and it's not something that he would ever buy for himself, which is the great part of giving a gift to someone, is, you know, thinking of those things that they would never purchase for themselves. So he will be getting that. Then I did just pick up like a little casual dry fit shirt from TJ Maxx, so $8. But I usually, if I see any of these shirts that he likes to just kind of lounge in or be in athletic shorts in, then I will pick them up. Or if I see a good pair of athletic shorts that I know what's the style he kind of likes now, or sweatpants, then I'll get those. But it's mainly just kind of if I see it, then I get it. I'm not on the hunt for anything specific because he is pretty particular. So if I see anything else, I'll add it to this. But this is always something I like to do, super easy, and I know he will wear it and get his use out of it. The next thing I'm getting him is just a little chopper for the kitchen. He is really into cooking, so he will be getting like a new set of cutting boards from one of our parents. He'll be getting some new utensils from one of our parents. And these are all the things that he puts on our wish list because he is into cooking, and it's something at this point now he probably cooks more than I do. So I just figured I'd get like a new little kitchen gadget. It was, I think, at Home Goods maybe. Oh yeah, here it is, $20. So if he doesn't love it, it's not gonna hurt my feelings, it's fine. But I do like trying to get him something kitchen-y every year. He typically wants a new pot or pan. That's been the last few years. We've been slowly upgrading our pots and pans, but he hadn't mentioned one that he wanted this year. So that was kind of, I don't really know what he's looking for. So I didn't wanna just get something that I thought would be good. So I just got something small. And then I think I'm gonna do, to go along with kitchen, is to do a month of a subscription service. So like HelloFresh, Home Chef, you know, I gotta do my research on what I wanna try. But since we do cook primarily at home, and he cooks a lot, I thought it'd just be fun for something for us to do, to try new recipes, see if we like it. And it's just nice to not have to plan meals every single week. So if it is something that we end up liking, then maybe we could do it, you know, once a month or every other month or whatever the case may be. But I am gonna add in a gift certificate for a delivery kit. I just haven't decided which one yet. So I'll print that off and put it with that. Then the next thing he'll be getting a new lunchbox. So he does take his lunch every day. And I typically replace his lunchbox maybe once or twice a year because they get pretty worn down. And I mean, I don't buy the best quality lunchboxes. So I mean, I kind of expect them to get worn down. So I saw that Yeti now has a lunchbox. I'm not sure how long they've had the lunchboxes, but I figured I'd just go ahead and get him a good quality lunchbox to last him because it is something that's used every day. And then they have the taller options, which I prefer because we do a lot of glass containers, but then they also have like the standard rectangle one. So he definitely won't be expecting this, but I mean, he'll use it every day and I know he'll really like it. And then I did get a couple of these. So I just figured it could go along with that gift. And we do need some more of these anyways, but I think the lunch boxes are like $75, $80. And then the ice packs, I think, are $10 each. So for like the lunch box, and if you get a couple ice packs, it does end up being around $100. But if you have someone who does meal prep or take their food, or like they like to have all their snacks and food in the car for a car trip, but they don't need the bigger cooler, then that may be a good option for them. And then I think this is the last thing I'm getting him. Yeah. Then the last thing is just a puzzle. If you know us, we love doing puzzles. This Ravensburger and Buffalo are our favorite brands. We've tried quite a few brands, but these are the ones that both of us really enjoy. And then my husband really loves puzzles where you can work on different sections. So I like the ones that are like a really pretty picture, you know, it's more scenic. That's not his favorite. So I figured I'd get one that he would actually enjoy doing. And we have not done this one. So that's always a plus, because by now I feel like we've done all of the Buffalo and almost all the Ravensburger. So he'll be getting a puzzle. And then the other little things in his stocking, he'll get, of course, I put candy in there. So I put like little things like this, gum. I do scratch offs. So just go to the gas station and get some scratch offs. Those are always fun for men. I do a new ornament. So all of us get a new ornament every year. So his will just be toilet paper with 2020 to remember the year. And then I will also do in his stocking an envelope with cash for a golf lesson. So he does enjoy taking golf lessons, and that's something easy I can do. So with the golf lesson and the food subscription, I think everything will probably be around 400 or so. I think right now I'm sitting around 300 is what I wrote down last. But that's typically what we spend, like the 3 to 5 on each other, something like that. But you can really just, it's whatever works for you and whatever your budget is. But just if you wanted kind of some small ideas or just out of the box things to do for your significant other or someone in your life that you're stuck on, hopefully that gave you some ideas. I definitely plan to just wrap his stuff up and be done. I don't really think I'm gonna get anything else aside from those two things that I mentioned. So hopefully this was helpful. Hopefully this gave you some incentive to start shopping or making a list or thinking of others or anything like that. And I will catch you in the next video. Bye.